or my home.
Ladies and gentlemen, coming after the game to the after party after the game, give it up for 9-time NBA defensive team, Gary Bates.
Yeah, it is. There it is.
Cut it.
Cut it.
Man, there we go. There we go. Let me get a little soda right here. That was pretty good right there. How y'all doing, man? Everybody
hey,
all right?
Hey, what's up?
I'm real, man. It's good. Let me tell y'all something. I got a big change in my radio show. Uh-oh. You know, I'm going to be by myself a little bit. You know, from now on, Speedy won't be with us no more. I'm sorry. It's one of them things that just happened. Had to work out.
An argument or something?
Well, you know, it was something like that. You know what I'm saying? It ain't really something like that.
Right,
but,
right.
You know, I got to do it by myself. But
right.
I got a good crew.
What's the name on the show?
It's called After the Game with Gary Payton. All right. So what's happening now? We got some. You know, I always going to have my boy Jess. You know, I ain't going to get rid of him.
Still here. Happy to be here, Gary.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, you here. You here. Come on. Tell me what I'm talking about this week.
All right. We got a lot to talk about this week, Gary. Where do you want to start? We got NBA lockout. We got NFL news. We got baseball. We got tennis. Anything you want.
Okay.
Let's
start off with the football because football season is coming up. Let's talk about that.
All right. With the football. Biggest news of the week, Michael Vick, $100 million, six-year contract extension with the Philadelphia Eagles. Second $100 million contract, only the third ever athlete to have that happen. Yeah. The other two, Alex Rodriguez and your boy Shaq.
Okay.
So those are the three. Vick got $100 million, and it's a six-year deal. So he's 31. He's going to be 37 if he plays through this whole contract. It's a pretty big contract and a pretty big leap of faith by the Eagles to give him that much money after 1 year.
Well, I think that's a good thing for Vic. He made a mistake about these dogs and stuff like that. here you go. You know, people out there is really, you know, onto their canines and stuff like that. They don't really want that to happen. Vic made a mistake. He came back. He's a great citizen now. He's playing great football. I'm very happy for him. You know, I heard that he's like $29 million in debt. They gave him $40 million guaranteed. He's going to pay $5 million for the six years, every year he's going to give it. And then he's going to do that and pay off everything. So I think it's great. You know,
and I understand he just got married.
Yeah, he did. He just got married to his longtime fiance, and that's a good thing, man. He got the kids. I think he's on the right track. I think he's doing it really good. I think Philadelphia knew what they had in him. 31 years old, he's still coming back. He's still the quarterback of the future to me. They say the Bradys, the Mannings. I think that them guys are more of an accurate quarterback. I think this guy is more versatile. He can get you a lot of things going on, and I think Philadelphia made the right choice.
And these are the dog days of summer.
So, boy, you something else. The dog days?
Come on. $100 million is nothing to bark at.
Hey, listen, man. Three guys, Alex Rodriguez, I don't think he should be in a 100. I think he should be in a 200 because he's got 250 twice. So, yeah. And then, you know, Shaq, you know, with his 100 twice. So, you know, that's good. I mean, I don't know how many people's going to do that again. I think LeBron's going to get it. One more time. I think so. Probably. I think he can get it one more time.
Kobe, maybe?
I think Dwayne might get it one more time.
Kobe won. He's too old.
Right. No, Kobe won't get it again. I don't think nobody would give him $100 million. He's too old right now. He's going in a later part of his career. But I think Dwayne and LeBron will get it again.
Well, Gary, you said Vic is obviously a different type of quarterback. He gets out and he runs. And one of the things that people criticize him for that is against him is that he'll get hurt because of the way that he plays. So do you think this is a risky move for the Eagles to give him 6 years on a contract, given the fact that he's already 31 years old and has had an injury history before?
Well, I don't think so, because the simple fact is he proved last year that he can sit in the pocket and throw the football now. Then as soon as he ran, he got hurt. Remember, he got hurt. I don't think he's going to do that. I think with the coach that he has now for Philadelphia, who is a great coach, I think Andy Reid is one of the greatest coaches ever, because he's a player's coach. You know, he adjusts to his players. So I think Andy is telling Vic right now, let's calm down a little bit, stay in the pocket, don't run too much. You know, if you see something happening, get down. And I think they made a great choice, because I think he knows how to play, and I don't think he'll get hurt.
All right, well, another contract negotiation that's been going on during the NFL offseason or preseason as we move forward to the regular season is Chris Johnson of the Tennessee Titans, and he's still holding out. He was on Twitter the other day telling fans to pray for him, even though the Titans are...
Hey, wait, hold on. What are you doing?
Oh man, I was getting me some soda.
We're on the air. They can hear you doing that.
Oh, I'm sorry.
855-369-9898. Go ahead, Jeff.
All right, so back to Chris Johnson. He was saying that he was telling fans to pray for him in his negotiations. He got some flack for that, and then on Twitter he responded telling fake Titan fans to shut up and that he doesn't have a regular job right now, so don't he doesn't care if they think he's greedy. But the Titans are offering to make him the highest paid running back in NFL history, but he wants a little bit more. So.
Well, I heard he wanted to be in the top, what, five or three in the NFL?
Well, he wanted to be the highest paid player in the entire league, not just running backs, like quarterbacks, well, running backs, everyone.
He needs to take his team to a championship and then ask. Am I right? Well, I mean, what is that?
Well, first of all, he's a little bit out of hand right now. You know what I'm saying? You're not better than Peyton Manning. You haven't did what he's done. You know, he done won three or four MVPs or won a Super Bowl. Right. Brady done won three championships. Yeah. Come on, man. Come on. You can't do anything. Your Titan team hasn't done anything. You rushed for 2,000 yards one season. Do that two and three times and then start talking to me about some things. You know what I'm saying? So I don't like that tweeting stuff with these players nowadays. Because all they do is get themselves in trouble. That's all they do.
The league was thinking about fining them for different things that they put on. You think that's fair?
I think what they should do is on any sport, you should keep your players off tweet. I think that should be off tweet, period.
If you were playing right now, you'd be tweeting and talking, you know, smack.
You'll talk smack when you're talking about whatever you play about your game. Don't talk about what you do on your job. Yeah. That should not be happening. Why would you tweet about your job? Why would you go in there and say, oh, shoot, my general manager is a butthole today and stuff like that? That's stupid. Yeah. I mean, they should keep them during their season. I really do think this. When you're in your season, you should be off tweet. You shouldn't even tweet because that'll save you money. Save you things because you got to understand these players sometime be frustrated when they get out of football games and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And they don't think when they go and do that tweet.
Yeah.
So you should leave them off of it and then make them fine. If you get on there, suspend them. You know what I'm saying? Then they'll think about what they're talking about, you know, or what they're doing. So it's one of the things that I just don't like the tweeting because it gets you in trouble. It gets you in trouble. That's how the wives and the husbands, they get in trouble by tweeting stuff to other people when people tweet back to you. You should stay off that mess, man, just for a little bit. I'm not saying don't do it during the off season or nothing. Have fun, but you just get yourself in trouble with these tweeting.
Yeah, Gary, it's funny you mentioned that. There was another Twitter controversy in the NFL just today and yesterday. Arian Foster, the running back for the Houston Texans, he tweeted a picture of the MRI of his hamstring injury, you know, making a joke out of it, saying it wasn't that serious. But now they've been going on SportsCenter and all these other outlets, like analyzing the injury basically and saying that it's more serious than he thinks it is. And basically all these other teams that are on their schedule can now look at this MRI and see how hurt he really is, and it's a big controversy
now. See, that's stupid stuff right there. Why would you do that? Why would you even tweet anybody about how you are hurt or whatever? You don't want nobody to know if you're hurt or not.
Right.
Because then what if you think you got players on there that's going to hit that injury and try to put you out the rest of your career or something?
How did you hide it when you were hurt? I mean, you
I never told them about it. If they see me get hurt, I wouldn't even say nothing about it. And then the media asks me, I'll be like, I'm okay. I'm fine. You know what I'm saying? And if I get out there and limp, and I see it, then they can see it. But if they don't see me limping and do the things, they don't know if I'm hurt. If I'm playing fine and it's killing me in the inside, I won't let them understand that. I won't let them see that because it's like that. But that's what I tell you about this tweeting stuff. This tweeting stuff is crazy, and you should get out of that, man. I mean, you're too grown for that to let everybody know everything you do.
Dwayne Wade does a lot of that.
Yeah, I mean, he does a lot of it. LeBron. But I think the tweeting is really for you to get – more followers and be a little bit popular, tweet something like a statement or something, or a word of the day or something like that. You can even put a contest on saying, okay, if you want to get popular, there's somebody came to me about this about 2 days, 3 days ago. They said, Gary Payton, you should have a contest. Have people answer things and give away your gloves because a lot of people like them glove shoes.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Have something every month that somebody can win and people will go to your Twitter and get more followers.
Yeah.
And I said, well, that's a good idea. Instead of talking about yesterday my mom came home and I told her, forget her, fuck her, and all that old stuff. Man, that's crazy, man. Why would you want to say something to tell people about what you did to your mama?
Right.
So I'm really not with the tweeting stuff.
What's your Twitter?
My Twitter, Gary Payton _20. And see, you know, I do tweeting. If people, even if people see me on my Twitter, they don't see me Twitter anything silly. You know what I'm saying? I don't Twitter nothing about my life. I think about this stuff here, you know, about the foxhole. People can get in touch with me about my job and then do things like that. That's a different story when you're doing things like that, and I think that's a little bit different.
And plus, Gary, you're out of the league now, too. It's not like you're playing for a team and have an organization that's watching everything you say. You're
Jess.
You're your own man. You're out of the league now, so it's a different story.
Right, and I'm on my own. Now, my stuff is about more of a promoting to get me something, you know what I'm saying? Get me something to help my life, help me, you know, help them. But, you know, these people working for these high-priced people, giving them millions of dollars, they should be concerned about what it's saying about their organization and how it looks.
Because you're still an employee.
Yeah, always. Always you're still an employee. You're working for them people, but you're going to make them look bad and make their organization look bad if you keep doing this because you're on their team. And they don't want that. But you know what? We've been talking a lot. We got that NFL out the way. We're going to get a little break. We'll be right back at y'all, all right?
Foxhole Radio. We're back with the Gary Payton Show.
Look, go this. Go. You get it back up. No, man, you got to pump that up. This is my, this is pop. Thank God. Just pop. Go pop. Go pop. Talk shit to me. Okay, cut it. Hey, did y'all see Jess? Jess was rocking off that shit. Get out, Jess.
I'm a big Tupac fan.
Okay,
so.
Really?
Can't hide that, yeah.
Really?
Damn
yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's what I'm talking about, Jess. You know what? You know what? Hit that again then.
Wait,
shit.
Bring it back then. Quentin Hill, back. Ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, Quentin. Come on, Quentin. What you say? This is Jess. Yeah, yeah. We ain't gonna say he coming up as a nigga though. Yeah. Hey!
You notice he stopped right before he said that.
How you want
coming up as a G.
How does it feel? Oh, cut it.
The Gary Payton Show.
That's how it is.
After the game.
Jess, what we got? What we got?
All right, Gary, we got college football coming back this week. It's been a little while, the off season, but it's back, coming back around. We got some big games this weekend.
And you know what? I like college football, y'all. I like it more than NFL. It
seems like they work harder.
For real, they work harder. The game's more exciting on a Saturday. You got 90,000 people, 50, 60, 70, 80, 100. They be coming with it, man. And they play hard. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And we got some big games coming up this week, don't we, Jess?
Yeah, two really big marquee games. The first one, the number 3 Oregon Ducks, number 4 LSU Tigers, number 3 versus number 4. That one's in a Cowboy Stadium in Dallas. So.
I'm going with the Tigers on that one.
No, they're going to get their ass whooped.
They
got a lot of players suspended. They main quarterback, he gone, Jefferson, for doing that little brawl or whatever, the little fight over the summer, right?
Yeah. Altercation just about a week ago got into it.
Okay, it's out. And Oregon, they say they're going to be doing it a little bit faster.
Well, why is it a big game if you know that LSU doesn't have a chance?
Because it's a big game. It was already scheduled as a big game, 3 and 4, but they didn't know these people were going to be suspended. So it would have been a great game. And it's a neutral site. Yeah. So, you know, LSU put this on themselves. So I think Oregon, coming out of the national championship, said they're going to be, you know, a little bit faster than last year. What, had 50 points a game? If you get a little bit faster, then you're going to have 100 points a game again. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I like the Boise State and Georgia game.
Yeah, that one is technically neutral site as well, but it's in the Georgia Dome.
Yes, so
not real neutral for Boise State, but Boise State ranked number 5, Georgia ranked number 19. I personally still like Boise State in this game.
Ooh. I think so, too.
Despite the home field.
But you know what? Listen, this is going to put a test to Boise State. Everybody's always say they have a weak schedule. I would like them to put on one more top-notch team. You know, a Florida or Florida State or somebody like that in the middle of the season. You know, people gonna say because if they beat Georgia right now, and I don't think Georgia is a strong team this year. You know what I'm saying? If they do, the running back's real good. Yeah. And then if they beat them in the Georgia Dome, they'll be like, oh, they proved a point. That's true. But this team has not lost anything. They still got their quarterback. Boise State still got their quarterback coming back. They got a lot of players coming back. They're a good football team. You know what I'm saying? So it's gonna be interesting to me, but I still like Boise State.
Yeah, and I think Boise State could possibly go undefeated this year, but like they have all the other years, be left out of the national championship game because, like you said, they don't have those big games on their schedule besides this one. This is really their big test, and they have TCU, but that's another smaller school.
Yeah, that's and they're not as strong as they was, too. They beat TCU like 2-3 years ago in that little bowl, and TCU was supposed to be ranked so high, and I didn't think they would rank that high. So I think they should have kept Oregon on their schedule.
Yeah, I mean,
they should have played Oregon again.
They played Oregon, as I said, 2 years ago.
Right.
Beat them, and that was another big game that they won. But as you said, they don't have enough when you compare it to the SEC or the Pac-12 or the other bigger conferences, and that's why they really don't get the respect. And as far as TCU won the Rose Bowl last year, but their quarterback went to the NFL. Right. They lost their best defensive player as well, so they're not going to be the same team. So Boise State likely won't get the respect they deserve, even if they are an undefeated team this year.
Well, yeah, you know, that's a weak conference. I think they should go into a better conference. I think they should move to something like a SEC or something like that. They should put themselves in a conference and then prove that they can beat teams on a regular basis. And I think that would help them a lot and put them really up there in the top teams in the country. You know what I'm saying? So we're going to go to some callers right now. I got one right now, Scott from Georgia. Come on, Scott.
Hey, Scott.
I wanted to talk to you about something else, man, but when you said that junk about Boise State moves somewhere to a conference like the SEC, come on, GP. The SEC is where the NFL guys are bred at, man.
Well, that's why we said – but, Scott, that's why we said they should move to the SEC, because these people are saying that they're a good team. If you think you're good, move to a good conference and then make yourself known.
They're not going to do it because they'll never be in a national title talk ever again.
But if they go to a SEC and start beating on them, some of them teams, they will be in a national title talk again.
They'll get the look.
They'll get a look.
Yeah.
I mean, why not go to somewhere where you can get a look? You know what I'm saying? To stop playing in these weak conferences and do it, go and step up. Step your game up. That's all you have to do.
I'm not going to move to the SEC because if they move to the SEC, Joe Five-Star is not going to Boise State. You know,
if it's enough money out there, they'll go anywhere. Any college will go anywhere if it's enough money. You know? Thanks for the call. What's up, Zell?
Yeah, I was thinking he's from Georgia, so you got to listen to what he was trying to say.
Yeah. He said Georgia ain't going to win because he was going to talk to me about about beat Georgia.
He changed.
He said he had another conversation. I got you, Scott. I got you.
Speaking of football players on Twitter, this is incredible. At Twitter.
Incredible.
Yeah. He says, having problems on Twitter during the season, the off season might be worse.
But if it's worse, then you ain't got too much to talk about. You ain't got nothing to talk about on your team. You don't have nothing. When you're in off season, you're doing whatever you're doing. You might be going to a club or something like that, but you ain't talking about your organization.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So, you know, you got to be – when they in there on the season, they're talking about their organization. That's why they're so messed up. You know what I'm saying? And when you're in off season, you ain't got too much to talk about.
Right.
You know?
So, right. Hey. Well, Chad Ochocinco seemed to have a lot to talk about.
But he's an entertainer.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? You
now,
ain't got too many entertainers. An entertainer mean a guy who has to stay in the limelight, who is trying to do other things. He's trying to become, after football, a movie star or whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
He's trying to be a businessman afterwards. And you know, that's what Terrell Owens did. Yeah. You know, now he's got a show that is really popular. So you know, you do that. That's what Dennis Rodman tried to do.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's what kind of guys
are doing.
He had a successful.
You know, they said that they were talking about Dennis Rodman.
Mm-hmm.
And how he wore the dress. Remember the dress he wore?
Oh, yeah, the wedding dress.
The wedding dress in New York, right? Was it in?
Yeah, he married himself, right?
Yeah.
He got $10 million for that.
Well, that's what I'm trying to say. You market yourself.
What about you?
What about me? Would I would have wore a dress?
For $10 million.
Damn sure would have. Shit. They'll put me on some Filitos, some Skettos, or whatever the motherfuckers called. I would have put them on. You know what I'm saying? I don't care. Yeah, if $10 million, I'm doing that. You know what I'm saying?
It's a good business deal for him.
It's a good business.
Okay, Chris Jackson. Chris Johnson, I'm sorry. You guys were talking about Chris Johnson. On Twitter, Coach M. Jinx says it's not a good move to not be in camp and not work hard. Hard work beats talent.
Yeah, I mean, hard work do beat talent. When you go out there and work harder, it's always going to be a plus for you. You know what I'm saying? And then it'll make you bit better than what you are. I mean, that's why you see on the NBA, when the NBA was drafting a lot of foreigners, They were drafting people who work hard and knew how to play the game.
What do you mean was? Are they doing it now?
No, nah, they not as much.
Who?
Not as much. I don't think they're drafting a lot of foreigners now. They drafted, well, I mean, in 1 year, they drafted almost 10, 11 foreigners in the first round. This year, they drafted, Jess, about three or four?
About five or ten.
Yeah, it was a little more this year, yeah. But as far as the past couple of years, it hasn't been nearly that high.
It went down, right. It went down because it was so many athletes, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And you coming out of college now only 1 year. You're only going to college 1 year. So it's a little bit different, you know? So that's what it is.
All right, let's go to Twitter again. Jesse, why don't you read the name of this
Twitter? Oh, no, I'm not going to read that one. God
The name of the Twitter handle is I'm a Twitter nigga.
Oh, dang. A Twitter nigga.
Regarding players using Twitter, I like talking to them between games and stuff.
See what I'm saying? That's what they want to hear. They want to talk to them between games and get them pumped up to do stuff and to say stuff that they ain't supposed to say. And I think it's not even – I don't even think it's right to do that. But, you know, they got this Twitter out here now, and that's the way it's going to be. They're going to keep it up until somebody put a stop to it.
All right, 855-369-9898, the Gary Payton After the Game Show. You have a caller.
Yeah, it's from Hurricane from Baton Rouge. Hurricane, dang, Harry, Hurricane, hey. Y'all have a lot of them down there, don't you?
Yeah, we have a few. We ain't had one since Gustav in 08. But okay. You're talking about LSU.
Yeah.
You know, I'm right there in the same city with LSU. And I don't think it's going to be a blowout like you think it is. LSU has a lot of talented players.
Mm-hmm.
As far as Jordan Jefferson, I think they is railroading this guy because it was a street fight. They didn't start it. They finished it. They didn't throw the first blows.
But you got to understand, Hurricane, it doesn't matter if you first started or whatever. Sometime when you're an athlete, it's always bad for you regardless of whatever happens. Mm. If you get hit and retaliate, who is it going to be talked about? You. So I think if he wasn't getting killed, he should have just bagged off a little bit, had one of his homeboys with him, whoever was with him, and took care of the situation because he know he's going to get the worst out of everything. Mm-hmm. I thought that way in my career. First thing I threw a blow, or I did anything, or I didn't throw a blow, next thing you know, my phone was ringing a week later from somebody's attorney talking about they suing me. Then I have to get all the attorneys, the money, and all that old stuff and squash it before I get in the papers.
Right.
So it's not a good look. I don't say it's right, but you got to understand, you're a high-profile athlete, and you will get in trouble.
Mm. Okay, let's talk about that thing that was squashed. Now, what happened?
See, here you go. You're trying to get him out.
What happened? Was it in Oakland? Was it doing one of your road trips?
I done had a couple of them, though, guys.
And actually, you actually fought someone or your boys?
Yeah, we actually did a lot of stuff, and me having a good agent then got a lot of it squashed. It was a lot of squashing. Didn't nobody know nothing about it. I done had about 8 or 9 incidents where nobody knew nothing about it.
But now that was probably in the 90s, early 2000s.
Yeah, early 90s.
Now you have the internet. Everybody's got camera phones.
Phones, yeah.
Don't you have to be more cautious
now? You got to be more careful now because once you start fighting, somebody's going to take that camera out and then they're going to want to sell it to somebody. This is what really happened. And then they got the camera phone on there. It's doing everything, videoing everything. And then all of a sudden, they're going to call you and tell them, man, I got this video, man. You're going to give me $20,000 or I'm going to get it to them. So it's just a little bit different. See, in my era, we didn't have them camera phones.
Yeah, we've been following you for 2 weeks. We can't find nothing on you.
You ain't going to find nothing on me. So it's all.
We're going to take a quick break real quick.
Oh, for sure. We gone, man.
We're going to pump some music in a minute.
But, hey, we'll be back in a hot second.
Gary Payton.
After the game.
Show. We're back to the Gary Payton After the Game Show with future Hall of Famer and future Radio Hall of Famer.
God dang right. Bitch, I'm a boss. Boy, y'all drinking syrup down there because you look what they saying. They just drinking syrup in that South. Okay, cut it.
Now, you telling the players to watch what they do. You done hyped the party up. Now, one player is now going to go do something illegal.
Well, now, if he listen to me talking about drinking some syrup, he crazy. You know what I'm saying? That boy crazy. But come on, Jess, get with our next one.
All right, we're moving on to the NBA right now. Obviously, day 62 of the lockout. The NBA owners and players met today for 6 hours, so the second time they met in the past couple weeks.
Then nothing happened.
nothing's happened, but at least both sides are like getting a little bit more of a sense of urgency now, saying that they're trying to get closer to a deal. If they are, doesn't look like it, but they met today, if that means anything. So
read the quote from Derek. Didn't Derek Fisher say something?
Yeah, Derek Fisher said, we just feel a little bit less or a little lot less of talking outside the room and more talking inside the room is better for everyone. So less talking to the media, more talking together.
Well, that should have been happening in the first place. Yeah. Everybody should have been in a room talking anyway. And then you can go out and talk to the media. They want a basketball season to happen. They got to get out and fight and do the stuff. They got to do this like the NFL. Even if you're not getting close, stay in the room and say something. See if some vibe happens, and that's what should happen. So these guys are going to start feeling the pressure if they don't start getting these checks by October, or they don't start by October and them checks start coming. So they need to get in there and just talk a little bit more.
What's your prediction? I know you have a lot of friends that are in the NBA, and what do they – maybe on both sides. You know both sides.
Well, everybody is both sides. I don't think the owner's going to give in. The players are seeming like they're trying to fight hard, and you know they're threatened about going overseas and all of those stuff. But you know, if they're talking now, so that's a little bit different. You know what I'm saying? It's after 62 days they're talking. So my prediction was they wasn't going to come back until January or something like that, or February, and then don't have no all-star game like they did and try to cut it to 40, 45 games, 50 games. And then that would have hurt the players. You remember when we did it, we played three games in a row, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday.
Yeah,
then was off on Thursday, and then we came back and played Friday, Saturday, five games in 6 nights. And that's hurt. That hurts people, you know. And
is
you
that
can
what
get
they
hurt.
Would have to do?
They would have to do that. They would have to make games up like that because of TV things, and then it'll go over into another sport. So they would have to do that.
Now, if the TV has a contract with the NBA, I think NBC carries the same.
They
got to
give
right?
it back. Give them money back over what games is not
right. They have
telecast.
Instead of being sued, they have to prorate whatever that season.
Whenever
is.
They have okay. to be, if they had a $3 billion contract, they have to give them back.
So Bob Costas still gets paid.
Yeah, he gets paid no matter what, because he's the one who does the games, you know, and whatever. And that ain't got nothing to do with him if they come on a lockout. So he's got to get paid. You know, they'll put him in the studio to do something else. You know, they'll talk about basketball or show like on NBA TV what they show all the old games and all that old stuff. WNBA, they just make up something. You know what I'm saying? Show all last year's game and show everything else, you know. So it'll just – TV has to go on, you know.
Yeah, and we meant one thing that was mentioned in the lockout. Carmelo Anthony was suggested, why not start the season anyway if they don't reach a deal and keep negotiating during the season? But that would bring up a whole other set of issues. They couldn't keep paying
you
the
can't
players.
Cross
but
that line.
Can't do that. And then what are you going to do? What rules are you going to go by of signing people?
Exactly.
They don't have any kind of boundaries of signing nobody.
No,
so if you
no scrub play, basketball. Huh?
So yeah, they're not going to go with the old thing the last year, so they don't have nothing. So who are you going to pay? If you go to a free agent and say, okay, here, I'm going to give you $500,000. No, ain't nobody going to do that. You don't even know what a guideline to go by. So that's not a good idea.
Yeah, and Gary, we mentioned obviously that you will be in the Hall of Fame in a couple years.
Yeah, year and a half.
Now, wait a minute. We talked about it earlier. You haven't been back on the air since he explained why he wasn't going in this year.
Yeah, why I'm not going in January is because I played in the 2007 season. You remember, I went from 06 to 07. We got eliminated the Chicago Bulls. They swept us. So that ended my career in 07 in April. Yeah. So in the NBA you have to be out 5 years of non-playing. So I started in 2008. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. That's the five, really 6 years. It's really counted 6 years. And then on 2013, I can be nominated in January.
Okay.
And Gary, we were mentioning the Hall of Fame, and I brought that up because today Yao Ming was saying that we remember that he was nominated early.
As an ambassador.
As an ambassador, he took his own name out, saying that he didn't think that was right. So he withdrew his own name and said he'll wait till the 5 years for him comes
right,
up. So
right.
he drew his name out.
And then people are saying now, will he make it as a player? You know what I'm saying?
Not at all.
Well, it depends. It depends on what kind. If he, because he's from China and stuff like that.
And we're trying
but
to get illegal.
People are not really would be really happy about that if he goes in as an ambassador in 2 years. And that wouldn't be nice. That wouldn't be good. And I compliment Yao Ming for that, because that is great, because a lot of players have to wait as many years and then he gets to do it in 2 years, and that's not right, and I think he made a right decision.
Yeah. Well,
going to Twitter quickly, It is, I am Aaron Perkins. Let's shout out for Aaron Perkins.
Aaron Perkins, shout
he
out.
He says, Gary Payton is a funny-ass person. He needs to join the TNT crew.
Well, Aaron, I did join the TNT crew, and they already had a couple of guys. And, yeah, you know, that's all what happens. You're going to get a funny guy now in Shaquille O'Neal. So he's joining the TNT guys.
Is C-Webb still on?
C-Webb is not on there. I think it's just going to be Shaq, Kenny, and Ernie and Charles. So it's going to be them four from now on.
That's going to be hilarious.
Yeah, they're going to have, but Shaq going to have a good. They're going to have a good time. They're going to have a lot of skits. I think it's going to be really funny. I think it's really going to be funny.
They're paying these guys pretty well, huh?
Yeah, I think Charles is getting about $2 million, $3 million, and then I think Kenny's getting about 1.5 or something, 1.2 or something like that. They're making good money, and you know Ernie's probably killing them. He's probably making about 2.5 or something like that.
Ernie's so amazing, though. He went they're making
a great deal of money, but you got to understand they've been winners, big winners, you know, them Oscar winners or whatever, nominees or whatever. They done won it a couple
so
times.
So do they do a show if there's no season?
I think they do. I think they just rerun everything, and then they just make it what happened. I don't think TNT is going to stop them from doing things. I think they're going to still do stuff.
Yeah, and Gary, you mentioned earlier that you liked Yao Ming's good decision. Move on to someone now who hasn't made good decisions in quite a while, and that's Javaris Crittenton. And he was of course, involved in that incident with Gilbert Arenas, the gun incident a couple years ago.
Right.
And then recently he was charged with murder in an August 19th shooting. Got arrested the other day, and now he's in jail, basically going to be awaiting trial. It's a pretty serious issue for Crittenton, who's in big trouble.
Well, yes, and with a guy with a lot of talent, young guy who just didn't it's not staring right. You know what I'm saying? Trouble seems to find him, and he's not doing it. I don't think he learned his lesson from the Gilbert Arenas thing when they all got suspended and they had the guns and everything, and they gambling and doing all this stuff. I think it's just a guy who is just lost, you know, had talent, didn't know what to happen. And kids, you got to understand this. And look, you know, things happen, man. I mean, you can get out of your hoods and ghettos, and you don't have to prove anything. You've made it. You know what I'm saying? Be yourself. You can be around all your homeboys and still be a good person, but you don't have to prove nothing like you hard. Now this guy has lost his career, did some things that it is not right, and now he's probably going to pay for it and go to jail. It's just like Ray Carruth, you know.
Wow.
Did stupid stuff, you know, for a woman who's having a baby. Let her have the baby and you deal with it, man. Be the father. Do what you have to do. And you're going to go try to kill her and then hide in trunks and stuff like that. And now you're in jail for 20 years to life. Yeah. So, all we can do is just pray for Creighton and I hope that the good things happen. And he didn't do it, you know. But, you know, he's got to learn a lesson.
And you talked about him making bad decisions. Jesse, you know, was talking about some of the good decisions earlier. You've made a decision to start doing Gary Payton basketball camps for kids.
Right.
And you just recently did one that ended up pretty well. So you're more of a one-on-one kind of person. How are you going to start?
Yeah, I'm more of a one-on-one person. A lot of people don't understand. I pick a lot of kids that I think that need to be helped, and then especially the ones that learn to listen. You know, they want to come to you. They're not have a big head and say, well, I learned more than him, whatever, whatever. When a guy like, Kobe comes to me at the All-Star game and wants to learn about his defense, I go and respect him for that because he's a younger guy trying to get better. So I'm just doing that. You know, I want to work out kids. I want to be around more kids. I did a camp in Angola in the Virgin Islands. It was really nice. You know what I'm saying? And we got that going now every year at a nice resort. So I'm trying to get it all back here. You know, I want kids to understand. I mean, people can tweet me, you know what I'm saying? And they can ask, you know, if I want to work the kids out or whatever, we can work it out or whatever. But that's what I'm trying to do. I'm just trying to help these needy kids.
There's some parents listening right now. Let's give them the number, 855-369-9898. If you want Gary Payton to put your kid in his camp, and you fly everywhere, right? You probably will end up doing them all over the country.
I probably can do everything. You know, we're trying to get it together and work it together and try to get it big. You know, I really want to go back to Oakland very much. You know, I want to do it there most of all, and in Seattle. Mm. So, but anywhere, you know, if it's something, a kid that I really like and I think he's got a motivation, I'll fly there and do whatever I have to do for him.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's good. Gary Payton, the glove camp. bring a glove and you get in free.
Go ahead, Jess.
All right, we're sticking on the NBA theme. Yesterday there was a game in Baltimore between or organized by Carmelo Anthony. He had his team, which included Chris Paul, LeBron James, Josh Selby, a couple other NBA players, against Kevin Durant in the Goodman League. So some players from D.C. Durant had 59 in the game. LeBron had 30. Carmelo had 27. So they put on a show. 149-141. Melo's team won in front of a 4,500 small crowd, but packed house at Morgan State University.
Well, that's a good thing. I think these guys are now understanding how to do things now. I think this is a show to how they need to do it. It's no basketball. A lot of people want to see all of this. And what is really making it happen is because they're going back into the hoods. That's what it's about.
It's like the Globetrotters.
Yeah, you're putting your show on display. And when they go back to these leagues that doesn't see these NBA players and go there, they're going to get 4,500 people, you know, and that's what it is. When Kobe went to the Drew League out here in L.A., yeah, which is a rough little league, yeah, and he went and had, 40-something, you know, mm-hmm, and did what he had to do, that makes a difference for these kids. He hit the game-winning bucket, and then all of a sudden he raises his hand in the middle and all the kids come swarming around and patting him on his chest. They like that.
So is that better than them going to Turkey? Because I talked to Ron Artest yesterday, who's got a new show coming on the Foxhole, and he said he didn't want to go to the UK because he wanted to stay here, mm-hmm, and do some games here so the kids can watch them.
Right, I think that's better. These people who are over here need to see these type of these guys. You know what I'm saying? I mean, if they want to go over to Turkey, I think a lot of these guys are making money. They need to be over here helping us a little, helping these kids out over here that's trying to keep them up. I just seen a guy, a high school guy. He's a 5'9" or something, Chris. And they call him the what they call him in his neighborhood? They call him the crime stopper, the kill stopper, because he say every time he play, all the killings stop because they come and see him play. You know what I'm saying? And he's got game too. He is nice. He turned out the Venice Beach thing here in L.A. last week. Killed him, man. And he only in the 10th grade. And he's doing this, and he called himself the Kill Stopper because all the killing stops, and every one of the killers come see him play. So I like that. I like the idea, man.
The police should be following him so they can catch solve some murders, unsolved mysteries at the court coming up this week.
Well, shoot. That game, well, I think LeBron and them is doing well. You know, they just keep going out. I think LeBron needs it. You know what I'm saying? With all the criticism he took, go out and stop hiding. You know, it's over with. That's over. Play basketball. I mean, I think all of them should play. And people would say, what if they get hurt? Okay, they can get hurt working out. You know what I'm saying? That's what basketball is about. Basketball is about that. You know, you take a chance going out there playing football, basketball, baseball. Anything can happen to you. So just go out and have fun, and it'll be okay. Jess?
Yeah, with that game, as you said, the streetball games really all summer. You mentioned Kobe playing in the Drew League. LeBron came to the Drew League. Kevin Durant, of course, at Rucker Park had the 66 points there. We've seen, just a whole bunch of NBA players staying here, although with all the talk about going overseas, they've stayed here, and they're playing against each other. So the competition is probably better here than it is overseas because they're still playing against NBA players.
Because they're playing against NBA players. And matter of fact, the guy I was talking about, his name, April Carr, he's 5'6", and he's from Baltimore. I think he should go and play in that little league with them. He'll probably show some of them dudes in the 10th grade what to do. You know, so I think the competition is a little bit more more stiff over here than going to playing at Turkey. They'll probably have an 80 every game, you know, Kobe, especially Kobe. So I think they should stay over here and let these people see their talents.
And what's your Twitter again?
Gary Payton _20.
The Real Taijuan 1 says that Yao Ming is very humble. He's a very nice guy, and it's very commendable. They like the Yao Ming.
That's good. That's good. Giving, I like that.
Giving back his
his ability, yeah.
And the other one is Brian Ain't Lying. That's twist.
Brian ain't lying. Boy, he's something else, boy.
Much respect for Yao Ming. He's been a class act. Good, so they really like that.
Yeah, they like that. I mean, when guy do that, man, if a guy does that and they try to give him something special, I think you should wait like everybody else. I mean, Michael Jordan waited 5 years. Charles Barkley waited 5 years. Everybody
you waited six.
Yeah, for them. Yeah. Same thing. Yeah, you know, but you got to wait. Just wait your turn. If you're going to make it, you're going to make it. It's no deal. You know, God knows what's going to happen. So if you make it, you make it.
Okay, we're getting ready to play a little town business. For those who don't know, that means Oakland, California.
You little Oakland, California. You gonna go with my thing. This is when Pac was jumping off, man. Let's rock with it, man. We gotta get it going on, man.
Yeah, man.
We're gonna give y'all some music for a minute, take a little break, but you're gonna listen to this song for a hot second, cause this is my thing right here.
Back to the worldwide.
Tell me what
Gary
you
Payton.
Tell me
what show. With show. Jesse.
And Jesse.
And Gary Payton.
Gary Payton. Here we go. Just tell me when to go. Tell me when to go. Dig on my boy. Dig on my boy. Hey, cut it. Hi.
Do you have any Chicago artists?
No, we don't
have
anything.
Everything is Oakland.
Did you hear him bumping like that?
Yeah,
boy,
I don't know what the hell he's saying.
But that's okay. We know what the hell he was saying.
Sound like you're eating chocolate. Jesse, you know the words?
A little bit, but not as much as the Tupac one. But I do know that song, of course.
Yeah. What we got, Jess?
We're going to move on now. We got tennis news and golf news. We'll start with the tennis news. Venus Williams has withdrawn from the U.S. Open after supposed to go to the second round. She revealed she had an illness. It's Jorgens syndrome, spelled S-J-O-G-R-E-N-S syndrome.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It's an autoimmune disease that causes fatigue and joint pain. They said there's no cure for it right now, but she's going to try to get treated. But she's dropped out of the U.S. Open.
She was winning, too.
Yeah, that's a sad thing, you know, because I know the Williams family really well. I know both of the girls and stuff since they was little. We went to the Olympics together. But we just going to pray for her and hope that she gets back. And hope this is not going to be the end of her career.
Yeah. You know?
Well, we're going to take one call. We're going to take Clyde from St. Louis. Come on, Clyde.
Hey, Clyde.
Hey, how y'all doing?
All right, Clyde.
Hey, Gary, how you doing?
I'm doing all right, Clyde.
Hey, this is the guy that said Michael Jordan whip your ass.
This is a fucked up Clyde. Oh, Clyde, you know what, man? I'm going to talk to your punk ass about that shit now, man. Fuck wrong with you talking about Michael Jordan whip my ass. Let's talk about that.
Okay, let's talk about it then.
What happened? What happened then?
Bring it on, brother.
Bring it on then. You know he didn't whoop my ass neither.
Yeah, Michael Jordan spanked your ass.
Hey, Clyde, you motherfucker, you must be about 80, man, because you know that shit didn't happen, boy. You know that shit didn't happen. I was kicking Michael Jordan ass.
Shit, Michael Jordan was popping off in your ass.
What you want to say, Clyde? Because you're a crazy motherfucker, boy. What you got to say?
Hey, I want to say, Gary, in all seriousness, you know, the ball players can do things to help in the community, but, you know, you need to have some other people, too. Like me, I've been coaching kids for years and trying to have an influence like that. And I think we need to have more just common folks trying to help these kids to move along in life. You understand what I'm saying?
Clyde, I think that was so, too, but you know what? We have to have some of these athletes who these people, these kids look up to come in there and get more of these common folks to get involved with it. If they come with us and do the same thing, and when we leave and they keep it going and get mentored like that and have like an AAU coach or a mentor of a center do that, I'm right with you on that. Just like my father, everybody is – like his dad, they say that's Pops because he went out on Oakland streets and raised everybody to play basketball. If we can get more fathers and more people like that in there, we need to do that. We know everybody needs to come together and try to help these kids, and I'm right with you on that. If we get more people that want to help, then I'm with all of what you're talking about.
We do need both, and you're right, kids do look up. The guys like you, you know, even though Michael Jordan kicked off in your ass.
Wait a minute, Clyde, tell us what game do you remember that happening in?
That was back in, when did y'all play, buddy, 92?
Yeah, 92. That's when he bust my ass in 92. Because if you said 96, that's a damn lie. But 92, he did beat my ass.
Yeah, 92, he stomped the mud hole in your ass.
Yeah. Hey, Clyde, I'm going to give you that. I was only 2 years in the league talking shit. He stumped the mud hole in my ass, but then I came back and stumped a mud hole in his ass, too. You know what I'm saying?
Gary, in all seriousness, I tell you, you were one of the best goddamn ball players ever played the game. I like your attitude. You come out there chewing that gum. You look like a goddamn camel chewing. But you look like a camel. But I tell you what, you would lock a motherfucker down. I tell you, you should have been the sheriff. They should have called you the sheriff. Because you could lock some people down. You just couldn't lock up Michael Jordan. That motherfucker was like Jesse James on your ass. He come
Hey, Clyde, you got to call back every week, man. God damn it, you got to call back.
Well, Clyde, we want you to get your team together, man, and we'll do a Gary Payton camp in St. Louis, and you head it up for us.
I would love to do that. As a matter of fact, Gary, I'm 75. I'll put my damn gym shoes on my shoes, and I'll take your ass to the hole. I love you, boy.
Thank you, man.
Hold on, Clyde. Don't hang up. We got to get your phone number. Don't hang up. Somebody else from Twitter, JWay270, says, I swear I can cross Gary Payton.
Man, shit, everybody always talking about they can cross me. Man, I'm 88 years old now. They ain't gone with all that shit. He can't do nothing. You should have got on one of them jerseys when I was playing in the league. It was 29 other ones, motherfuckers. I ain't see you now. They're 9-1 now. You motherfuckers, stop with that bullshit. Man, that was 18 years ago. Shit, come on, man.
You still got game, though.
Man, I can bust it. I'll bust his ass. He just don't understand it. Even at the age of 43, I'll tear his head off. You know what I'm saying? Hey, boy, that boy Clyde, a crazy motherfucker.
Clyde's the caller of the day. Caller of the day.
Yes, caller of the day. Yeah. Yes, give me my last one, man.
All right, last story we got. Tiger Woods, Guy Black, you were talking about this earlier. He was saying that he hasn't played very well in a long, long time.
Shitty.
He said he sucked.
He said he is shitty.
And one of his fellow golfers agreed, saying that he loves the way Tiger Woods plays, but he's disgusted with what's going on with him because it's sad for our game. A lot of guys are happy Tiger isn't playing well. I'm not, and that's Rocco Mediate. And Rocco's right. He's not getting as much money. Everyone gets more money when Tiger plays.
Yeah, because we never knew
who
the hell Rocco was until his story came out. So, Rocco, you doing yourself justice.
Well, shit, I'm with Rocco, shit. I'll be fucked up, too. I'll be mad as hell at Tiger, man, shit. Once he play good, I get more money.
TV ratings are down less than one third.
Yeah,
when
shit.
He doesn't play.
Well, fuck. I mean, he golf. You know what I'm saying? So shit. Even if he fucked up and playing bad, he still the shit. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. We ain't got no caller. We ain't got no more last caller for the night. We ain't got nothing. Well, ain't nobody want to zoom in and shit.
Digital Underground kind of took up your time.
That's okay, man. I don't give a damn.
E-40.
I mean, shit.
Maybe you'll play some other regional artists.
Now we just gotta wrap this shit up. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, no, next week we gonna play
put
Florida.
Some of my shit back on. Put my nigga 40 back on, man. I'ma ride the show out like that. Fuck you, Guy Black.
Okay, Quentin.
Fuck you, Guy Black.
No R. Kelly, nothing?
No, fuck that. We coming with the Oakland.
No Rick Ross?
No, boom, boom. Hey, get in. This my nigga 40. Here it go. We in it on this note.
Yeah,
get it.
Let it play. Let it go.
Bye, 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 bye.